إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونصلي ونسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise due to Allah, we praise Him and we seek the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide him, and whomever misguided, no one will guide him. I bear witness and I believe there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty, and Muhammad is the last and final messenger. الصحابة والصحابيات رضي الله عنهم الصحابة والصحابيات رضي الله عنهم الصحابة والصحابيات رضي الله عنهم. May Allah please with the companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from male and female. And we still continue and talking about the life of Sahaba, and we are selecting women among the Sahaba, as-Sahabiyat, radiyallahu anhum. Today, inshallah, we're going to talk about one lady. This lady is amazing. Amazing character. Amazing character of love towards her husband. Amazing character in sabr and patient. Amazing character with her behave and akhlaq. An amazing character in love towards Islam. Amazing character in love towards her father, whom is the best man whom walk over this earth, Muhammadun sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who is this lady? Zainabu bintu Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Zainabu bintu Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. زينب بنت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Whom his father محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The messenger of Allah, the one Allah sent him to save the humanity and take the people from the darkness to the light, from the evilness to the goodness, from miserable life and ignorant to the light and the beauty of Al-Islam. She live and she grow up in this kind of house. What do you think this lady and this girl or this woman will learn? She being disciplined by the school of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best school. Zainabu bintu al-Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom her mother Khadija bintu Khuwaylid radiyallahu anha, the one is the most beloved to the heart of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He loved her so much. She was the mother of all, the mother of his children. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has two boys from Khadija and four girls from Khadija. The boy Abdullah wa al-Qasim. Only Maria, and she was a servant, she delivered to him Ibrahim, and he died when he was 2 years old. Died. So all the other children from Khadija radiallahu anha. The one Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loved her so much, that one time in the seerah, in the story of Prophet Muhammad, when a lady, she knocked the door and she say, when they say whom, and he hear her voice dissimilar of the voice of Khadija. He said, who? This is Hala. the sister of Khadija, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam so much excited and give so much hadiyah. He was so happy as remind him the biased and the modest and the most closest to his heart, Khadija radiallahu anha. Taqulu Aisha, I haven't been jealous the way I jealous from Khadija, and she already dead in that time. She's not alive when Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam married Aisha. Khadija already passed away. And Nabi Sallam, because he mentioned her name so much, Aisha, she said, the most I have a jealousy towards is Khadija. And one time Aisha, she said, Allah replace you better than her. Yani, you marry young, she was old. Nabi Sallam, he said, no, Allah did not replace me better than her. She saved me when the time, the people, and protect me when the people try to harm me. She support me with her money and her wealth. She was, subhanAllah, Khadija, she all her life sacrificed for Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Until the last moment when she farewell the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is, we learn that the heart of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa what do you call, never forget the goodness. And that's what Muslims should. When somebody good to you, never forget that goodness from him, from his side. So the mother, one of the amazing Sayyida, Khadija radiallahu anha. Zainab, she is the oldest child among of the children of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She is the oldest. She born before Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received the message from Allah, the revelation, 10 years. And later Zainab radiallahu anha, she married with Abu al-As, and that he was her cousin. Her was Abu al-As, her cousin from the mother's side. So Zainab radiallahu anha, she loved her husband so much and she cared about him so much. One of the story showing that Zainab radiallahu anha, how much she loved her husband, and she was a kind and very good wife towards her husband. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the message to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi, she became a Muslim, and all the children of Rasul sallallahu become a Muslim. Her husband refused. Al-As, Abu al-As, he refused to be a Muslim. He wanted to remain in the kufr. And in that time, in the time of Mecca, Sharia the revelation not yet sent, revealed down that if a person become a Muslim, she must, separate from him. This is wasn't came. Because Allah later sent the Sharia, the law, وَلَا تُمْسِكُوا بِعِصَمِ الْكَوَافِرِ. So if the lady, she become a Muslim, she must separate from the husband, unless if he declared to Islam, then alhamdulillah, everything okay, they can come back to each other. Then Zainab, she become a Muslim, her husband refused. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrate from Mecca to Medina, and he take with him her sister Ruqayya, and her sister Ummu Kulthum, and her sister Fatima radiallahu anhum jami'an. All of them migrate with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, except Zainab. Zainab remain with her husband. Subhanallah. Showing in Islam how much the woman should love her husband and give him an honor. Although Abu al-Wa'il, he wasn't Abu al-As, he wasn't Muslim. Zainab radiallahu anha, she was weak in that situation. She became a weak because she doesn't have any supporter except husband. And even her husband, non-Muslim, his heart and his honor towards his own family, the kuffar. So what happened? When the battlefield occur of Badr, her husband Abu al-Wa'il, he went with the kuffar of Quraysh and he fought an Nabi sallallahu alayhi. Allahu Akbar. You're going to find your father-in-law? Something in the, why? Because the ignorant, the kufr, the darkness of jahiliyyah. Oh, my heart towards my tribes, my heart towards my father religion. Okay, he joined and he fought against the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Battle of Badr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the victory to the Muslim. 70 from the kuffar being what do you call taken as a
hostage.
70 from the kuffar of Quraysh being taken as a hostage. Here Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam doesn't know who they are. The rule is, in order to be freed, you have one of the two options. You have money, your family have money, so they can free you. Or you teach 10 among of the Sahaba how to read and write. And here show the Islam care about education. Nabi Sallam, he doesn't say to them, okay, only salah, only prayer, only jihad, only fight. No, also educate. Lift up the ummah, the education. And we always say, change the nation through education. Now ummah al-Islamiyah, now we need the education more than the sword. We need the knowledge more than the sword. So Al-As, alhamdulillah, Abu al-As, her husband, he was among of the hostage. Zainab radiallahu anha, she loved her husband so much, she sent one bag, it's inside something, and she sent to all the way to Medina. And Nabi Sallam received, and they say, what is this? They say, this is the money, freedom to free Abu al-As. Nabi Sallam, he opened, what he see inside? A necklace. That necklace, Khadija, his wife, gave very wealthy, amazing, unique, made out of gold. Unique necklace that Khadija radiallahu anha, when Zainab married, she gave her as a hadiyah to her daughter. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in that moment, he get emotional and remember Khadija. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also remember his own daughter. She is alone in Mecca. She is weak. She is poor. She doesn't have any supporter. And all the children with him except her. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his heart becomes softened. And in this moment, as a father, he's a father, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, missing his daughter. And he knows she's struggle alone there between the kuffar. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, A'idu laha, yani, what do you think if you can return back the necklace to her because she is a poor and she is weak, and return back to her husband. And he gave them the opinion. Look at even Nabi Sallam, he's a Rasul, he's a leader, of the army. Still, he doesn't give a command or order in this, because the people say, because the husband of his daughter, he will, or because he's related to him, so he will free him. No. Nabi Sallam, he asked him, is it okay to return back the qila, the necklace to her and her husband to her? And here in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, some of them, the kuffar, the hostage, there is one person, he free him without money, without teaching. When they ask him, you have to teach, he said, I don't know how to read and write. He said, you have to pay little bit money. He said, wallahi, I have only daughter and their mother died and I don't have any supporter to them. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam free him freely. So look at the akhlaq of Islam. Look at now the hostage, what they do. If you've been captured by the war, أعوذ بالله, they will, you know, treat you evilly, and they will punish you, and they might kill you and cut you. We see a lot of video how they treat the hostage of the war. Subhanallah. But look at the Islam, akhlaq al-Islam. Even the Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم ordered the Sahaba, قال أحسنوا إلى أسراكم, be nice and good to your hostage. There's another word, hostage and captain, is it? President of the war. President of the war. So أحسنوا حتى قالوا الصحابة, الصحابة رضي الله عنهم said, we used to the hostage, the president of the war, they are together, and the tamar, the date, because the Medina, the city of Medina, it's full of the date. Mecca doesn't have a date. The people of Quraysh buy the date from Medina. So when the Sahaba get the date, they give the hostage before the security or the guard eat. And the prisoner of the war, they said to him, why you don't eat? He said, you eat first. If anything left, we eat. They shocked from the akhlaq of the Islam. Allahu Akbar. What kind of akhlaq? This kind of akhlaq. Allahu Akbar. That's what we need. Then Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam free him. He returned back to, but he asked him a condition to return back daughter Zainab back to Medina. Then when he went back, he freed Zainab, and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam sent two of the Sahaba to get her all the way to Medina. Her husband, when he told her to go, he said, I will not go with you now because I'm worried that Kufar of Quraysh will do something to you. So he sent his brother. When she went with a camel, going to go out, group of Kufar of Quraysh stopped her. And they said, you will not allow you to go out since your father fought us. And we are lost in the Battle of Badr. And subhanAllah, one person scared her with an arrow, and she was pregnant. Out of terror, she miscarried, and she started bleeding. Zainab radiallahu anha. Her, the brother of the husband, here the ownership of Arabian, they have ownership. How come she's under my secure? The brain will explode. This is a culturally with the Arab. Somebody is under my care and somebody tried to attack him, here he will explode. He threw he took all the arrow from him, 20, and he said, by the name of God, if anybody come closer to us, I will throw 20, I will kill 20 among of you. Then you can kill me, no problem. Then Abu Sufyan was with the group, he said, bring your arrow back and put it back and we leave you. But with the condition that you come back, return home, and only she can go in the night, not openly. We will not allow a lady, her father fought us, to leave the city openly in the day. Then subhanAllah, she went in the night, and the Sahaba, two from Sahaba, take her all the way to Medina, and she returned back to her father. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was so happy, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when his daughter Zainab returned back, radiallahu anha, to him. Later on, Abu al-As again, in that time they put a border, something like kind of border. This is the border of Medina, this is the border of Mecca. So in that time between Quraysh and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam situation, war. So sometimes the Quraysh caught people traveling, sometimes the Muslim caught from the Quraysh traveling. There is a conflict. Then one time, Abu al-As, he coming back from Sham, he being caught by the Muslim again. So he being captured or hostage or prisoner of the war again. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam doesn't know about that. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, peace be upon him, pray Salatul Fajr, and Zainab, she find out, she call openly from the window, who can be a good and kind and to towards my husband to free him again, Zainab. Then the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam again asked the Sahaba, are you willing to free him again? Subhanallah, after he showed him Islam. Nabi Sallam talked to him about Islam. Firstly, he said, I don't want to Islam, but if you free me, you free a person, he is generous and good. Nabi Sallam, he tell him again about Islam. He said, no, but if you free me, you will free a person, he is generous and good. Then Nabi Sallam, after he invited him to Islam, and he refused, he free him. Then he come back to Mecca, he sold all his stuff, and he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, and he returned back to Medina. And here show, I will not be a Muslim because I'm weak, or I am in hostage, or they have ownership, the kind of ownership. You free me, then I will come back a Muslim with the full of honor, not because I'm weak or under pressure or under anything. Subhanallah, Al-As bin Abu Al-As, he returned back as a Muslim and he joined his wife Zainab radiallahu anha again. Here two stories show the Zainab radiallahu anha how much she is honored and loved to her, towards her husband, that her husband fought her father, and her husband kafir, non-Muslim. With all this problem, still Zainab radiallahu anha, she asked two times to free her husband after he been captured. Subhanallah. And here show the love towards the husband. Subhanallah. Something is really, really amazing. Allah placed in the heart of the pure Muslimah, pure woman, which she has a good heart, sound heart, kind heart. She will never forget the goodness. Subhanallah. Even her husband traveled all the way to fight Prophet Muhammad, fight her father. And he being hostage, she also free him. Subhanallah. And he's a kafir. Still, she was a good. Subhanallah. And as I told you, the first story, the Islam, the ruling of Sharia came down that the Muslim, when the lady she became Muslim, she must separate. This is the ruling came after Zainab radiallahu anha. The reverse of the Quran, Allah says, وَلَا تُنْكِحُ الْمُشْرِكَاتِ حَتَّى يُؤْمِنْ وَلَا أَمَةٌ مُؤْمِنَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِنْ مُشْرِكَاتٍ وَلَا أَعْجَبَكُمْ. Allah forbid the believer to marry non-believer, mushrika. And Allah forbid the lady Muslima to marry non-Muslim. This is the ruling of Islam. So if somebody asks, is it allowed for me to marry non-Muslim? If she's a Christian or Jewish, halal for the man. But for the woman, she's not allowed to marry non-Muslim. And this is the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the man, he has the power and control. If she is a Muslima, he will try, maybe force her to change her faith. She will not be free in her faith, and she will be a pressure on her. But in the opposite side, the man is allowed to only marry a Christian or Jews. We are not allowed to marry non-mushrika. So if somebody said, this lady, she look okay, she's beautiful, she's alright, but she's mushrika, you are haram. You are not allowed to marry mushrika billah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, after her husband, Zainab radiallahu anha, her husband returned back, she only lived with him 1 year. Then she passed away. Radiallahu anha. She only lived with him 1 year and she passed away. Zainab radiallahu anha, showing how much she is a good, how much she sacrificed for sake of Allah, how much she has a sabr and patience, how much she has a good akhlaq and manners. Zainab radiallahu anha. She gave birth with one daughter and one son. Her son passed away when he was a child. And also her daughter, her name Umaymah. Umaymah, her daughter. Her daughter name Umama. And Umama, she grew up, and after Fatima radiallahu anha, she passed away. Ali radiallahu anha marry Umama, the daughter of Zainab. And after he married her, later she died, and there's no any generation came from Umama. only the generation of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or distance or chain, okay, from the Fatima radiallahu anha, al-Hasan wal-Husayn wa Ummu Kulthum. So here the family of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam remain from that chain only, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So this is the story of Zainab radiallahu anha. We learn a lot of lessons from her beautiful story. We learn that Zainab radiallahu anha, she has an amazing and deep faith. She has an amazing and deep love to Allah. Even when she, Nabi Sam left her in Mecca, all this pressure from her husband, all the pressure from all the kuffar, will not twist her down to leave Islam. Nowadays, we see some woman, she become a Muslim, little pressure, little situation, oh, I cannot handle. Maybe she will change back to kuffar and say, I cannot handle anymore the situation, I better come back to Christian. Or any pressure or try to play in her brain, she will accept. No, look at Zainab, with all this pressure, remain in Islam and faith, because she tasted the sweetness of Iman, the sweetness of believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believing in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, we learn from her story how the wife should love her husband, and she stand with him in the hardship. Many women, they said, I love my husband, but when he is in situation, Allah musta'an, she's the first one run away from the situation. Or opposite, the man, he said, I love my wife so much, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test her with some of trial, he the first person run away. I know, I have one friend, mashallah, with me, he's a very religious, very pious, in Australia. His wife, she, Allah test her with a hard trial that she has a cancer. Wallahi, I shocked about his sabr for 1 year or 2 years, remaining next to her, serving her, I mean, take care about her, take care about the children, and he did not marry. SubhanAllah, show like in that. He said, in the time when ease, she was so much sacrificed to me. Now is my turn to pay back. SubhanAllah. So showing that the love between the couple should based by the sacrifice. And Islam encourage us to sacrifice. Islam all based of sacrificing. SubhanAllah. Also what we learn from Zainab radiallahu anha, a lesson that when a person declared the Islam, one of the sunnah to run away from the bad environment to the good environment. She, when her father said, come to Medina, she did not say, oh no, I want to remain there. I want to remain in Mecca. I want to remain with my husband. Or I want, no, for sake of Allah, everything become easy for me. Although she get scared and she, what you call, miscarriage out of the terror, she still went in the night and she traveled to Medina. So learning the lesson that if you become a Muslim, or if you are Muslima and you repent to Allah, you should change the environment, the bad one. If you work in the environment of work, all haram, of course your iman will drop down. So unfortunately, I see nowadays a Muslim, he's a good, he will find work in bad and evil way. He said, it's okay for sake of money. Then later on, he start losing the salah. He start missing the salah. Then later on, he will involve in haram. Then he eat haram. Then he will do all haram. Then between him and the kufr, maybe just knocking the door. True or not? So this is what we learn. The true Muslima or true Muslim, both of them encouraged to look and search for the good environment, because losing money, no problem, but losing your faith is the biggest problem. Alright, this is the second some of the lesson we learn from the story of Zainab radiallahu anha. Also what we can learn from her lessons from her story from her story that sabr, patience. Sabr, even she is a weak and woman and whatever, she remained in Mecca for a long time, and she has a sabr and patience. And when she come back to Mecca, also she has a sabr with the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam until she meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So sabr is the key of opening. Sabr is the key of Jannah. Without sabr, how you can get the Jannah? Sabr is very, very important. This is some of the lessons we learn from the story of Zainab. May Allah radiyallahu anha, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us and gather all of us, inshallah, and whomever hearing this story in Jannah. Ameen, ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma adkhilna al-Jannah. اللهم ادخلنا الجنة اللهم ادخلنا الجنة وأجرنا من النار اللهم يا مثبت القلوب والأبصار ثبت قلوبنا على دينك ويا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا إلى طاعتك ومحبتك وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا سبحانك اللهم ربنا وحمدنا أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت Any question or any things you'd like to add or comment inshallah
just like question the situation what if a married couple, yeah, then the wife accept Islam, and then the husband doesn't want, is she obliged to separate?
Yes. According to the question, as I said, Zainab radiallahu anha, in the beginning, the ruling of Islam wasn't come down. So it was a rule, even the lady, she's Muslimah, she can marry non-Muslim. In the Mecca time, of the period of Mecca, there is no ruling came yet. When the people migrate to Medina, the ruling of Allah starting come over the Muslims to establish the system. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed down that we are not allowed. Even before, in the time of Mecca, when Muslim want to marry kafira, no problem. Mushrika, no problem. But when the ruling came, khalas. Finished.
But they are already married when she embraced Islam.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's why Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he asked Abu al-As to send Zainab back to Medina. Here there's separation. Separate from each other. If he declared the Islam, they can come back to each other. The husband not declared the Islam, he is not allowed to come back to each other. And in that situation, the lady, if she lost hope that her husband doesn't want to accept Islam and she would like to marry a Muslim man, here she can ask for separation or elimination of the marriage. Or she has other options, she can remain and wait until he accept Islam. Then alhamdulillah, you can return back to her. So she cannot live with him anymore since she declared Islam and he's a mushrik or kafir. Alright, is not allowed to remain with him in Islamic ruling. قال تعالى ولا تمسكوا بعصم الكوافر عن قال تعالى ولا تنكحوا المشركات حتى يؤمن. So the ruling is she has to wait. If she think, inshallah, he will learn or need little time to understand Islam, then he accept. Alhamdulillah, she tried to give him da'wah, give him a book, invite some ustaz to talk to him, do all the possible way that he will know the truth, true or not. If he reject, he doesn't want, he want to remain in the darkness, he doesn't want to embrace the truth. This is the truth, very clear. Islam believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one, and Prophet Muhammad is a messenger of Allah. The Quran is all the signs, is a clear and evidence that existence of Allah, and you worship creation, not worship the creator. So when deliver to him message and then he still doesn't want to accept, he want to be in blind and darkness, here no. She has to separate from him. And I recommend if she can subhanAllah leave him, and she can marry a Muslim man who can give her more, make her more strong in her faith and to remain firmly to in Islam. And wallahi, any person leave something for Allah, surely Allah will give him better. You leave something for Allah, wallahi Allah will return better for you. Many people left their country for sake of Allah, then Allah honored them in the other country and make them better life. SubhanAllah. So when you leave something for Allah, believe in Allah, Allah will replace something better for you. Look at the people of when they left Mecca, Allah give them the victorious and establish a country and give them freedom in Medina, where before they've been tortured. So you leave something for Allah, surely Allah will take care about you and help you. Okay, Ustaza?
In what surah that men and women cannot marry? Not because in Indonesia, they marry and stay married, Muslim and non-Muslim. So, in what surah?
There is two surah talking about this ruling. One surah, ولا تمسكوا بعصم الكوافر واسألوا ما أنفقتم وليسألوا ما أنفقوا, سورة الممتحنة. Okay. And another surah, ولا تنكحوا المشركات حتى يؤمن. Don't marry المشركة until they believe. ولا تنكحوا المشركين حتى يؤمنوا. And not allow the مشرك man marry Muslima, Muslim lady. And this is Surah Al-Baqarah. Surah Al-Baqarah. A very clear ruling of Islam about this. And this is from the weakness and jahl, ignorant, where the people, they implement this, it's okay. No, it's not okay. It's not okay. This is not nikah. This is zina. والعياذ بالله. Zina. Because...
The Muslim film star in Hollywood.
This is not, we cannot say it marriage. He can take her out of the villa in the haram partner. It's up to him if he would like to take this. Marriage should be between the believer with the believer. Understand? We are allowed only to marry Christian or Jews. If with the condition they are modest, you're not allowed to marry a lady. She has a 5 boyfriend. Astaghfirullah. Here, haram. Allah says, "ولا متخذات أخدان." قال تعالى سورة المائدة. قال وطعام الذين أوتوا الكتاب حل لكم وطعامهم حل لا وطعام الذين أوتوا الكتاب حل لكم وطعامهم حل وطعامكم حل لهم والمحصنات من المؤمنات والمحصنات من الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم إذا آتيتموهن أجورهن محصنين غير مسافحين ولا متخذي أخدان. Allah says the food of the people of the book allowed to be eaten by us. To eat their food, and our food is allowed to for them to eat from us, because the people of the book, they have the message, they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At least the God, they know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they have a revelation, they have a prophet. Okay. And wal muhsanat mean the women from the people of the book, we are allowed to marry from them, but with the condition they doesn't have a partnership other man, okay, other than her husband, partnership or friendship or making zina or adultery, haram. Here we're not allowed. Astaghfirullah. So this is a ruling of Islam, and Allah has sent this ruling to save our ummah from misguidance, save the ummah. Can you imagine if a Muslim lady, she marry kafir, how much he will put the pressure on her in her faith and her deen and her akhlaq and her behavior, and if she has a children, the children she will not have a power over them. They might, wal'iyadhu billah, her own children go to the misguidance. So in Islam, in order to protect this and save this from beginning, alhamdulillah, zakum Allah.
Yeah? If the married couple and the wife become Muslim, then the husband, he doesn't want to embrace Islam, and then maybe she cannot able to leave him until he pass away. What is the ruling? What is the...
No problem. It's up to her, but she is not allowed to live with him in any relationship. She want to remain waiting. Maybe he will be a Muslim one day.
They will still together until he pass away.
Here, that not a halal.
What is the punishment or any?
This is that relationship is illegal relationship. That's relationship.
It's
illegal.
If the man already passed away, it's over.
If we have an Islamic ruling, an Islamic country, okay, the sheikh or the lawyer, the judge should force, not allowed, and she will be punished by the law if she remain with him. You understand? But unfortunately, we don't have the country which rule the Islam. So in that case, she will be sinful by doing this. Yeah, she will be sinful by doing this. But if she is waiting, she doesn't have a relationship with him, but she's waiting, maybe have a hope that he will return to Islam, is not necessary. She must marry another person. No, it's not necessary. She can remain, wait for him until he embraces Islam, or he died. It's up to her, her choice. But relive with him, have a relationship with him, that is not lawful and not allowed. it's elimination. The marriage already eliminate. Since she declared Islam and faith, and he not declared the Islam and faith. So this is a ruling of Islam, and I hope our Muslim women understand and implement the law of Allah, because the law of Allah only can solve their problem. Otherwise, the problem will be bigger and bigger later on, and they will become, the case will become worse and worse. So Islam, in order to protect her faith and her ownership and her deen and her akhlaq, she must follow the rule of Islam. Jazakumullah khair, and Allah knows the best. سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك صلى الله عليه وسلم محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين